Now that we're logged into our server as the student user, let's try and run a sudo command. We'll try and run sudo cat etc. password. We're asked for a sudo password for the student, which is just the standard password we set for the user when we initially made the user. We now get this warning. The student is not in the sudoers file. This incident will be reported. Our student does not have permission to use the sudo command, so let's fix that. I've switched back to my other terminal where I'm logged in as vagrant. This is a user we know can run sudo commands. They can perform administrative tasks. Now, the list of users that are allowed to do this is within the /etc/sudoers file. Let's read that file using sudo cat /etc/sudoers. Here we can see that the root user is listed, along with a few groups using % and then the name of the group. On some systems, you would just add the student user, just like this, using a special program called vi-sudo that's allowed to edit this file. But on Ubuntu, it handles it a bit differently. If you look at the very bottom of this file, there's a directive here that says include dir /sudoers.d. This command tells the system to also look through any files in /etc/sudoers.d and include those as if they were written directly within this file. This is a common pattern, since distribution updates could overwrite this file, and if that were to happen, you would lose all of the users you added. By keeping your customizations in this other directory, the system eliminates that risk. Let's see what files are currently included in that directory by running sudo ls /etc/sudoers.d. We see a file here called vagrant, and that makes sense, since we're actually using sudo here. Even though vagrant wasn't within our /etc/sudoers file itself, this file is being included by this directory, giving this user the permissions it needs.